So this is basically Christian concept, because how we constitute the linear time, generally time is circular. So if you look at all traditional cultures, also Greek culture, they understood time as circular, based on circular processes taking place in nature. So every year is repeated by the next year, and a certain era is repeated by the next year, and so on and so on. So if you look at the Indian tradition, look at the Chinese tradition, look at tradition, Greek tradition, it's all circular time. Linear time is time between promise and fulfilling of this promise. Yeah, so it's a time of waiting. So I get a promise, and then I wait and wait and wait until this promise is fulfilled. And that is condition of the Christian subject, yeah? Christian subject gets a promise of return of Christ, end of times, and beginning of post-apocalyptic time. So, and what Christians are doing, they are waiting for this moment. This waiting for the fulfillment of a promise is, and there's interesting essays by Benjamin about that, is a principle of capitalism. Because capitalism is based on faith, is based on credit. So, is based on somebody giving money, so somebody giving money to me and waiting that I give this money back. Yeah. So this credit, so belief in the return, so belief in the return of Christ or belief in the return of money, is a basis of European historical thinking and economic thinking, and in general societal structure. So we have this end of history, beginning of history is a promise. In this sense, communism is, according to Fukuyama, as the last promise. Yeah, so communism was promised, and so people were waiting for the realization of this promise. And then they abandoned this process of waiting. They abandoned this process of waiting, and so they abandoned history altogether. We see that the ends of history have their own history. So we have end of history as French Revolution, we had end of history as October Revolution in Kharkiv, and then end of history as end of communism. Now, I remember this time very well. In 19th and beginning of the next century, this book by Fukuyama was very much discussed, and discussed in terms of loss of promise, loss of utopia, loss of historical perspective. And people said, no, it's not true. So ecology came, and this came, and that came. So utopia is not lost, promise is not lost. We're still waiting for the better time, and so on. So that was That was a criticism at that time, or tone of discussions. And some other people said, no, we don't wait for anything. We accept things as they are. But what was...